You are listening to the Sauce Podcast. Recorded live deep beneath historic downtown Seneca Falls, New York. In the FingerLakes1.com studios. Featuring Dandy, Gary, Tony Sometime, and Saucy Mike. Mike, check. And now, Mike, check. Good evening, Sauce Pod streamers everywhere. It's me, Tony Sometimes, and this is episode number 73 of the Sauce Podcast, recorded live in the studios of FingerLakes1.com, deep beneath historic downtown Seneca Falls, New York. It is Monday, October 15th, 2012, and it is Monday, October 15th, 2012. And tonight, we're going to be talking about extreme cheapskates. What came out of my back about 5 hours ago?
Oh my gosh.
How fresh was that enema you bought at a Florida pharmacy? A numerologist's delight in Des Moines, Iowa. A small penis contest in Denmark. And much, much more. So put the kids to bed early tonight. Per usual, I'm joined up here with my saucy compañeros. Dandy, Aaron D.
I can't wait for this hour.
And Saucy Joe.
The hour to be over or just to enjoy the hour?
Just to enjoy the hour.
Oh, me too.
And back in the studio, a founding Sauce Pod host. You know him as Media Stu.
Glad to be back with my compañeros.
And, of course, we have someone next to Stu on the couch tonight, and that would be Hunting Dog sitting in studio tonight. What's up, Hunting Dog?
Well.
So, hold on tight. We're in for a heck of a show.
I think so.
Tonight.
Look out for that mic.
It'll bite you.
So, Dandy, last episode, you were downtrodden. You were not in the best of places. If your fortunes turned.
He's grinning. Look
a little
at him.
Bit.
Yeah, they think you got your car back,
got
I heard.
Got my car back. Still no computer charger. Shower still leaks. Dog's still an asshole.
One out of four ain't
and
bad.
And you forgot to take home that body wash.
I know. How could you do that?
I forgot.
How could you do
body
that?
Body wash. What do you mean?
Well, Hunting Dog.
Yes.
If you were a regular viewer of the Sauce Pod, you would have seen that last week we recommended Johnson & Johnson Soothing Vapor Bath.
Is that produced by
Johnson & Johnson?
Yes, okay. Yeah.
Is that much like Vicks VapoRub?
It's what it smells like.
Yeah, but it's like a body wash.
And it'll cure your depression?
Well, that's what we were proposing for Dandy.
Yeah, if he went home and lathered up with that stuff, he'd feel a little bit better.
He wanted me to take a shower in my leaky shower with some new body wash.
Where is it? Leaking from drain or?
He was just so miserable last week that we were trying anything we could to get him up, you know?
I just want to mention that,
washing
Stu, Stu's back. Stu's back. Home Stu's back.
I'm back.
I love him.
That's what you should have brought me last week.
I love you, Stu. I love you back, buddy.
What's that?
I love you back here.
Speaking of back.
You're home. You're home where you belong.
Right where I belong.
You don't even.
Speaking of backs, I had a cyst in my back for several years. Maybe 5-6 years now, and it would get a little bigger, and then it would get smaller, and sometimes when it got smaller, it would smell a little bit, you know what I mean? It was disgusting.
How could you smell your back cyst?
Well, that's a thing, because it was inside my back, but it would, like, you know, it would, like, grow and then leak a little bit.
It oozes.
And sometimes when it would, but it was mostly internal, you know? There wasn't, like, any, like, what would you call that stuff? Spillage or
discharge.
Leakage, discharge. Yeah, there wasn't any discharge, ever any discharge. and this is kind of disgusting to talk about, but today I finally, you just wait it out.
No. It's worse, Aaron. It's worse.
Listen to Hunting Dog.
It's worse.
I've heard it.
So I had an appointment today to finally get the cyst removed from my back, and was excited about it. Now, I also had a ganglion cyst on my hand once, and that came off, and that was pretty easy, about a 15-minute procedure.
Ganglion.
So they told me this would take about a half an hour. I was under the knife for about an hour and a half, but great staff. I had, well, let me set the stage. I show up in the room.
Back up.
You want me to back up? You got something for me?
No. Like, I
oh, I'm just trying to reset this
They
thing.
Said half hour. He's in there for an hour half, and a half. Yeah. It's like an iceberg. Just a tip showing, and they went under. And they didn't
that's what she said. It was like an iceberg.
Did you guys ever
say that?
Did you guys see Jim's cyst he had on his hand? It was pretty bad. It was pretty gross.
I do remember his hand.
It was
gangly
and
hands.
He wants to keep it on his you know.
In a jar?
Yes, he does.
If you rip out your back cyst in a jar, I'm going to fucking leave.
Well, what are your thoughts on that?
No.
Of keeping your cyst in the jar.
Your ganglion cyst in a hand jar, a jar?
Jim wants to do it. You guys know, you've heard him talk about it. He wants to keep it. He feels like it's his little boy. Like his, you know.
Let's hear this. It once belonged to him. He grew it.
Yes, he did grow it.
Wait till you hear the rest of how he grew this one.
So anyways, I go into the room, and there are two, a nurse practitioner actually performs the procedure. Her name was Jackie, and she was fantastic. And there was also a trainee, another nurse.
Hello,
who was in there.
Nurse.
So I get in there, and they start taking my vitals. They tell me to take my shirt off. So now I'm sitting in this room, you know, and I had to sit on the edge of the thing. So it's like when my shirt's off and I'm standing, that's okay.
Yeah, but when you got to bend over.
But when you're sitting down, it's...
Yeah, but now with your new cleanly shaven chest.
I don't shave my chest. Where'd you get that from?
His underarms are shaved.
Oh, yeah, underarm. And I'm glad I did for situations like that.
I'm sure that really improved your situation while you were sitting there with
your
shirt off.
Trim them up.
You shave your pits?
Whoa. I missed that episode.
I did. That was like maybe 10 episodes ago where I decided to do that.
And how's that working out for you?
Well, I haven't done it since,
ten
but
episodes
it's
of what?
More unkempt.
The sauce pot.
This show that you're on right now.
I got you.
So anyways, that was a little embarrassing. Finally, I lay down on my stomach, and that's uncomfortable to lay like that for an hour and a half, but they give me the local anesthesia, and that does kill the pain, but you can feel the tugging and the pulling and the sawing. And the thing is, she wanted to do a good job for me.
Sawing?
Well, with a scalpel, you know.
Dig it out.
So, because the wrong way to do it is
melon
to puncture
baller.
That thing.
Yep. Yeah.
If you puncture it, there's a chance of infection, and there's a good chance it might grow back, too. So the way she explained to me was she wanted to get right underneath it and get that thing at the point.
Take a healthy margin around the outer.
And they kept saying stuff like, oh, man, this one's really, really attached. Hard. This one doesn't want to come out. And in my mind, I had it. You slice it out, pop it out, and you're on your way.
It's attached to your body in every respect.
And it was close to my spine.
Yeah, it's not just something that's sitting in there loose like a ball. It's all tissue connected to the rest of your tissue.
Yeah, so she had to saw off the scar tissue, you know. So it was kind of gross. But anyways,
kind of.
When it came out, I asked to see it, and it was literally the size of a golf ball. And I then took a photo of it.
And sent it to me immediately. And I opened my email, and there it was.
And I can share that with you guys, too,
right
gonna
now. It's going to be great. Look at your screen right now.
Yeah, if you don't want to see this, turn away. But if you do want to see it.
I don't want to see it. I can't.
Okay.
I have to see it. Yeah. I see Jessamy's happy face right now.
Yeah, that's the cyst. No, that's actually the cyst.
The cyst looks just at a top.
It's unbelievable.
Yeah. Okay, there it is.
My Lord.
Oh, it's like a stick. It's like a stick.
Now, for reference, that's a dime
that's
on
a
the
dime
bottom there underneath the lower.
Jim, where was that?
Tony. My name's Tony Sometimes.
Tony Sometimes. Where was that?
That was in my back.
Wow.
Look at that.
It looks delicious.
It looks like a plum pit.
Yeah, it does.
Before, it wasn't that red when I first saw it. It looked like a little tiny brain.
It probably oxidized, a little bit. And
Jay Nasty says it looks like a boneless wing.
With like a fire sauce on it.
It's definitely boneless. Certainly. It's definitely boneless.
Well.
Wow. It's something.
It really is something.
It is something.
So that happened today.
Yeah. And I tell you what, I'm in a lot of pain right now. My back really hurts.
What happened?
That's Tony sometimes.
Well, you're growing a peach fat in your back.
Was it laser surgery?
No, it was mechanical scalpel and torsets. And
so do you have a divot, golf ball-sized divot in your back?
Well, she told me. She said, now that took up a lot of space, so now there's a hole, and it will eventually fill in, but sometimes it fills in with too much fluid, and you'll have to call us back, and they basically said she'd prick it.
Yeah,
and I said, "Well, can't I do that at home?" And she's like, "No, you better come in for that if that happens." But hopefully,
they want to see you with your shirt off again.
Obviously. That's right.
I got to get this guy back in here.
Another neat thing about it was they were both Finger Lakes One users, so that was kind of cool.
So maybe they're watching this right now.
Well, I told them, I took the picture. I said, "Now I'd like to use this. I'm on the podcast, and I'd like to use this photo tonight. You think there'd be any problems with that?" And she went to check with someone else, but. The end of the day, it's my property of me.
Yeah, that belongs to you.
You know,
it's your property. Yeah, no, really.
That is yours.
No, it is. It's Eric Hartman shit, man. Yeah,
it's something else.
No, that's not.
It's fucking gross. Is what it is.
So there's a.
Yeah.
Why you got shit growing inside of you?
I don't know. Some people get cysts. You know.
I have one right now on my back, just like that. I imagine underneath, like the Titanic.
It's got something
like
to do with you guys sitting around all these fucking computers all day.
You think that's what it is?
There's a correlation there.
I don't know. I think it's just people get them. A lot of they're different kinds of cysts.
Mine has been dormant for like 2 years now, but it flared up at one point.
I wonder if I got any sweet cysts.
You probably do.
Now you like them? You think they're sweet?
You want one now?
I want a cyst.
I got a couple sweet cysts.
new show coming to like TLC or something. It's about extreme cheapskates. I don't know if you guys have seen this.
No.
But
I haven't seen that.
It's let me read a little bit.
Okay.
Some frugal people are so good at pinching pennies that they leave their thumbprint on Abe Lincoln's face.
That's stupid.
Take Terrence Candell, a California man, so cheap. That he keeps no furniture in his Oakland home and painted his entire house on a single bucket of paint. Furniture is a keeping up with the Joneses thing, Candell told the Huffington Post. It doesn't give anything back. As a financial investment,
right.
It's probably
not. But
the
show
so good.
Would be a lot less feasible without furniture right now.
We're all sitting in Indian style on the floor. Yeah, so he earned a spot on the new TLC series, debuting October 16th.
Hey, anybody know who's watching? I'm Jimmy Kimmel tonight, Honey Boo Boo and her mom.
All right.
I'm Jimmy Kimmel tonight. Watch it, please.
Honey Boo Boo.
Everybody watch it, please, and see what tomorrow.
I haven't seen Honey. I don't even know what Honey Boo Boo looks like. I've heard a lot about Honey Boo Boo.
We played a bunch of fucking highlight clips. Yeah. She's awesome.
You probably have to tell her that she's awesome, yeah. You probably have to say, "Wow, she's doing great." That's what you have to say, right? The kids, yeah. So Honey Boo was doing great.
Just great.
Honey Boo was doing great.
Oh, she's great. Yeah, she does. Oh, just great.
She's great.
Just great. I like things that are great.
Certainly, Candell qualifies. He is as a extreme cheapskate. He's so cheap that on his. That on the rare occasion he takes his family out to a restaurant, he opts for a budget Chinese buffet and has six people split three plates of food. Everybody gets some food, he explained. Plus, two of the people that weren't really supposed to come along, the tight-fistedness annoys his family to no end, but Candell believes that money only buys happiness if you don't actually spend it. So there's a new show coming up, I don't know.
Yeah, I'd watch it. Tight-fistedness, is that what you said?
That's what the show is called.
Well, that's not, no, that it's called said? Extreme Cheapskates.
Tight-fistedness, what'd you say?
Victoria Hunt is a self-made millionaire in Columbus, Ohio, who lives on $12,000 in part by putting her freezer on a timer.
You gotta
stand down, Hunt Dog. You gotta stand down right now. Who lives on 12,000? No, jeez.
We gotta get security in here.
Oh,
escort.
This is live.
She's a hunt.
This is live, Hunting Dog.
Yes.
who lives on $12,000 in part by putting her freezer on a timer so it only runs 12 hours a day and taking showers at her gym to save electricity and water.
Wow. You said something about she takes showers. She takes showers at gin? Is that what you said?
She takes showers at gin?
Gin, yeah.
She also saves $2 a month in water bills by urinating in a bottle and emptying it in the garden.
Oh, who doesn't do that?
Yeah. I mean, it's common sense. Listen, why pay for the water?
Simon does that.
And
all the time.
Does he?
Really? In the garden.
I'm guessing. I love Simon. He's a fucking cute kid.
Me too.
Is he like not? Is he really not? Listen, Stu, tell me, what's going on with that kid? Do you love him? You hate him?
You love your son, Stu?
Newsflash, Stu hates his kid. Yeah, fuck
I love my kid very much.
Okay, stand down, hun dog, for a moment.
Sorry, stand down.
Sorry. Jesus Christ. What can I do? I love Stu.
Or how about...
I love Dandy Boy.
Stand down for a second so I can get through this story here.
Listen.
Honey Dog Stand Down is going to be the name of this episode.
That's fine. Ted Kelly's producing the show. I know he is.
He's in the back room.
He said he's got great, weed. He's out.
Or how about Roy Haynes, who runs a pet rescue center in Huntington, Vermont?
Dude, are you watching Pet Bulls and Parolees? I love that show on fucking Animal Planet.
No, hold on.
Sorry.
He digs through movie theater trash cans looking for old drink cups and popcorn canisters so he can take advantage of free refills. Wow. And he hangs up his dental floss to dry so he can reuse it later.
Don't do it to me.
Don't do it.
So those are some extreme cheapskates.
Listen, that man doesn't like it or something.
Let's find out what's going on up here tonight in terms of beverages.
Man drink like that, he's going to eat. He is going to die.
We save hard drinks in here for men who want to get drunk fast.
This bad babe, a lot of pieces of the poet excited on the job.
You've been talk, man. What the fuck's the matter with you?
Saucy Joe, what are you drinking tonight?
Drinking a Saranac Pale Ale. Pretty standard for me. One of my
stand
go-to.
Stand down, hun dog.
This is one of my go-to drinks up here.
I love Stu.
Saranac Pale Ale for Saucy Joe. And how about you, Dandy? What are you drinking tonight?
Vitamin water. Power C.
Power C.
Sorry.
Now, Stu, how about you? What are you drinking tonight?
I got a Canada Dry Diet. Ginger ale. Check it out.
Diet, huh? Diet ginger ale?
Diet ginger ale.
Hun dog, what are you drinking tonight?
I have a vodka.
You got to get in front of the mic. You got to come back.
Yeah. He's standing down.
No, he's standing up.
I'm drinking vodka and 7-Up. I just want to tell you that I love everybody out there.
Really?
He's got a lot of love.
24 people. You love 24 people.
Yeah, I love.
What exactly does he have going on right now?
Nothing. I know Brad's watching. I know Brad's listening. What's going on right now?
Hi, Brad.
And over here, I'm...
Oh, we're live?
Yeah, we are live. What did you think? That was the outro music?
Yeah, I thought that.
We've been live for a long time now.
I got a Dunkin' Donuts coffee medium cream and one sugar.
That doesn't surprise me at all. Jim's a fucking Dunkin' Donuts guy.
I'm on the job.
Yeah, doesn't surprise me either.
Okay, doesn't surprise me at all.
Doesn't surprise me either.
There it is, the wide shot.
I love him for that. I love him.
Stu, feel
him. I feel the love from Hunt in a major way tonight.
Yeah. I
love him.
What can I say? I love Stu.
I love Hunt Dog.
Yeah. You guys know you love Stu?
Yeah, I love Stu. Look at him.
You love Hunt Dog?
I love Hunt Dog.
Come on, sit down, Hunt Dog.
Have a seat. Put your earbuds.
Put your earphones back on.
I got them.
Don't keister your buds.
don't keister your earbuds.
I know someone I listen to. I know someone.
Mink you.
I work for this company.
We're back. Ace.
I'm fucking
cameraman.
I'm the ace cameraman.
Ace cameraman.
According to the mayor of Newark, I'm the ace cameraman.
He's true. You know.
That's true.
Who loves Hunting Dog?
The mayor of Newark, New York.
Loves him.
Helen Blandino, I love you, Hunter. Yes.
Yes, hello.
Right, can you feel the love tonight? Yes.
Want to get into some news?
Sure.
Items?
I thought we already did that.
No, that wasn't really news. That was just a new show coming up with some stories about extreme cheapskates. I thought we might be able to talk about cheapskatedness, but...
Wait. You say extreme cheesecakes, or what did you say?
Yes, extreme cheesecakes. That's another show. It's on food.
It sounds delicious.
How do you feel about pumpkin cheesecake?
I love it.
Pumpkin, I think everything. It works.
Pumpkin everything. Make pumpkin in it.
Does Jenna make it, or do you make it, Stu? Pumpkin cheesecake? Really?
I don't make the cheesecake. I've had pumpkin cheesecake.
Yeah.
Wegmans.
Oh.
Look for it.
I like making pumpkin soup this time of year.
I've had the pumpkin soup.
And Emily, pumpkin soup ain't like the greatest thing ever, but, you know, it's a nice change of pace.
It's like squash soup. It's the same
pumpkin
deal.
Pumpkin soup? Yeah.
It's not an everyday soup.
What do you mean by pumpkin soup? What do you put in that?
A little pumpkin?
Pumpkin, yeah. Mostly.
Are you actually, you want to know how I make pumpkin soup?
Yeah, I want to know. Yeah.
All right.
I
break it down.
I will take some shallots and some garlic and dice them up nice and fine and get them going in a little olive oil. And then sometimes I put a little Tabasco sauce in that mix too, right in the beginning. Then I will go to a couple cans of pumpkin. Don't get pumpkin pie filling though. You can't be sweet. You need to just get straight pumpkin in the can. Sometimes it's hard to find, but don't get pumpkin filling because it's too sweet.
Soup.
Yeah. And then from there, sometimes I'll throw some jalapenos in at the beginning, too. But basically, a little chicken broth.
Yeah.
A little chicken broth, a little pumpkin filling. You get it going. And then you throw in a little cream at the end and mix it up nice. And there you go. It's good to serve.
Sounds good.
Yep. But I can't eat too much of that. Too much pumpkin soup's bad. But anyways, Dateline, Holland Township, Michigan. Man cooking squirrel for lunch sparks fire that destroys 8 apartments.
Dang.
A fire that destroyed 8 units in an apartment complex in Holland Township, Michigan is believed to have been sparked by a man using a propane torch to cook a squirrel for lunch, the fire chief said.
What?
The resident was on a deck on the third floor of the Clearview Apartments. He was using the torch to burn off the squirrel's fur when the deck caught fire, Fire Chief Jim Koshel told MLive.com. The resident, whose name was not released, was removing the animal's fur in preparation to eat it. Flames spread to the roof and other parts of the building. 8 apartments were destroyed and 24 other units were damaged. So,
seems like you would just want to... Skin the squirrel, dress the squirrel a little bit.
Yeah.
Why burning its fur off with a torch? It seems like a terrible idea.
Yeah, I think that was. I think that's a crazy person.
Yeah, skin it first. And
he's clearly no hunter.
No, and clearly no hunting dog. No. Hunting dog. How would you prepare a squirrel if you were going to eat it?
I would skin it.
You would skin it,
and then propane torch it.
I would take the fur off.
Right.
With a propane torch or a scalpel?
I would do it with a scalpel. And then I wanted to fucking eat it.
Nah. Raw. Just raw? Just raw, you would eat it.
Tartar.
Tartar.
Squirrel tartar.
Squirrel tartar.
Okay.
Zippy.
That's what I...
So are you not down with that, Stu?
That's the answer I expected.
I think it'd be a little sinewy.
Do you think so? A little gamey?
Well, you'd soak it in buttermilk and then eat it tartar style.
Yeah. Boiled over hard, probably.
But over par?
No, over hard.
Parboiled?
Milk squirrel. Boiled over hard. That would I have.
What's going on in the chat room tonight, Dandy? Anything?
Milk squirrel.
Yeah.
Jay Nasty's in there, Roger.
Oh, boy.
Congratulations to Jay Nasty and his band of merry men who completed the Chewed Gum Podcast episode 1 last Wednesday night. They'll be back this Wednesday at 8 o'clock.
Be there.
And, some funny stories on there. Some good times.
I enjoyed it.
You should join them for that one too, Hunting Dog.
I hear you.
You should sit in on every podcast.
Hunting Dog is just a feature.
Just spend the whole podcast. Week right up here in this studio.
Congratulations to them, by the way. Yeah, that's great. That's great.
Congratulations to Jay Nasty and
yes.
Bub
and
Tito and Q.
And Stu.
Tito. And congratulations to Stu. Yeah.
Oh, look at you.
Just look at you.
This is my brother's cigarette.
Do you want one?
Yeah.
OK. Can you not light this place on fire?
Probably not, but yeah, we'll see.
Dateline, Sunshine State, Florida.
Stu Crandall. Dateline Crandall.
Okay.
Sorry.
Florida governor gives out sex number instead of one for meningitis hotline.
Dang.
Florida Governor Rick Scott mistakenly sent Floridians seeking information on a deadly fungal meningitis outbreak to a sex hotline. Scott was at a Florida cabinet meeting on Tuesday when he announced a toll-free hotline's 866 number, but mixed up the numbers, according to WUSF News.
That shit makes me horny.
Meningitis?
Meningitis makes me horny.
After WUSF News, a public radio station in Tampa, posted the number online, a reader...
My parents are proud of me.
A reader notified the news station that the number was directing callers to a very different service. Hello, boys. Thank you for calling me on my anniversary, a woman's voice says in the recording. So, that was a little bit of a gaffe, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, sure, yeah.
Big time gaffe?
Feel like that.
Hey, I'm a first time caller. Jim?
Tony?
I just want to say, this penis is equal.
He's cracking himself up.
You got to stand down, hunt dog, right now. You're going to be sorry about when you watch this.
I'm just kidding, man. I work for FingerLakes1.com. I'm a fucking proud veteran with fucking everything you could ever imagine. I watch Homeland.
I watch Homeland.
The things that are running through his head right now. It's got to be incredible.
Jasper's like, looking like a terrorist.
I'm crying. Crying.
Fucking incredible.
Incroyable.
Incroyable. Zutalur.
Zutador. Incroyable.
Dateline, Jacksonville, Florida. Used enemas allegedly returned to Florida's pharmacy.
That's just nasty.
It is.
Prosecutors say a Florida man resealed, in return, used enemas to pharmacies who resold them to unsuspecting customers.
Oh my.
34-year-old Ronald Eugene Robinson of Jacksonville faces federal charges of tampering with consumer products. If convicted, he faces a maximum penalty of 10 years in prison and a $250,000 fine. Authorities say the customers who purchased the used enemas have been notified. I would rather they just
seriously,
didn't.
Seriously, I wish they wouldn't call me about that.
Oh, please call
imagine
me.
Imagine you got that call, Danny. Oh, the enema that you bought last week and used just 5 minutes ago was actually pre-used.
I would hope that I didn't use it.
By a 34-year-old man.
Named Ronald Eugene
Robinson.
Who then
repackaged it and gave it back to the store. Who then sold it to you and you used it.
If I used it, I'd have a lot of money.
Because you too.
Fuck yeah.
What does enema mean?
You'd have a lot of money, but you'd also have had the juices of another man's ass in your ass.
Oh, yeah.
Gross.
I'm just saying. As much money as you want.
Yeah,
take
on.
It.
And some Hep C to boot.
And some Hep C, right.
It's great, man. You're getting really in-depth, man. Fuck.
Yeah, you're getting really in-depth tonight. Dateline, Poughkeepsie, Wisconsin. Not even loss of leg can stop hunting dog.
Of course, not even loss of leg can stop hunting dog. What a great headline.
That's not a real story, but it
was
at one point.
It was a real story.
Funny
as hell. Boy refrigerator eats own foot. It's true.
That's true.
Yeah.
Another one.
If you watch Airplane, you believe that, yeah.
That's true.
Okay. Let's go Dateline, Naples, Florida. Three in a row from Florida.
They're always from Florida.
Yeah, it's not a surprise, I suppose. Machete-wielding man on bicycle crashes girl's birthday party, steals beer, eats own foot.
Dang.
That sounds like a Brenzone fucking... Question. Yeah, sorry. Oh, I say fucking sorry.
You can say that, but it does have its limits.
I love Brenzone. Well, you know, I love Brenzone. I love that guy.
Florida police are investigating a highly unusual stabbing that took place Tuesday evening. A man reportedly crashed a young girl's birthday party wielding a machete and attempting to steal beer.
Machete.
And before being chased off, the man allegedly swung the machete at the father of the birthday girl, clipping his right pinky until it dangled.
Really?
I think that's a little more than clipping it.
Just give the guy the beer. You know? It's just a birthday party.
Well, apparently the Naples News reports that the 42-year-old father was hosting the party for his daughter when the man described as an acquaintance showed up and started loading beer into plastic bags and attempted to ride away on his bicycle. When the host tried to stop him, he pulled the machete from his waistband.
I was that acquaintance. Yeah, right.
Was that your birthday party?
It was your machete. Your bicycle.
This sounds like bath salts to
yes.
me.
I've done bath salts. I've eaten faces, yeah. I will eat your face, too.
Great. I thought you loved me.
You would love to eat your face.
I love your face, sweet
breads. Yeah, you know I would. You know.
Wow. That's a bad mishap at a birthday party.
Yeah, because it's terrible.
That's horrible.
Terrible thing. He wanted the beer, obviously. He knew there was beer there and attempted to steal it. One more domestic news story here that I wanted to get in tonight. Let's see. Dateline Des Moines, Iowa.
I watch Homeland.
Des Moines.
He's on fire. Hot dog's on fire right now.
I think he's on fire. Are you serious? I love Homeland. You guys watch Homeland? Anybody watch Homeland? Are you serious? The best show ever.
Des Moines baby, a numerologist delights. A dream alignment for numerologists has come true in the delivery room of a Des Moines hospital. The Des Moines Register reports that Lila Fitzgerald weighed 8 pounds, 9 ounces when she was born. She came into the world on Thursday, which numerically speaking was 10, 11, 12. Military speaking at 13, 14, which would be 1:14 p.m. for civilians, like everybody here but Hunt Dog.
I bet Lila Fitzgerald was fucking 100,000 pounds, that fucking fat bitch.
It's just a newborn baby.
Lila's mother, 26-year-old Katie Deremia of Des Moines, said she had a feeling Thursday would be the day. And the father said he was going to buy a lottery ticket. That's just numbers lining up.
Yeah.
Happenstance or?
Yes.
Coincidence then, you're saying?
Complete happenstance right there.
Complete happenstance. It's people. Well, the numbers are just there. People draw the correlations they want.
Right.
They're applying their own structures to it.
And they're stretching it when they say the military time is 13-14. That just adds to it. But, And who's to say that? Don't they usually say the date first and then the time? But in this case, since the time.
Let's switch it around because it fits our cool story.
That's true. I don't believe that.
They sound like terrorists, son, dog.
Destiny Unicorn's a terrorist.
And anyways, let's kick it over now and see what we got in the old mailbag.
Oh, the mailbag? I got a question from somebody that says Jess Mader is a terrorist.
Put your headphones on.
I love Homeland. I watch Homeland.
What's his name? Yeah, I love that guy.
What's in the mailbag, Dandy?
Subject: Space Jump.
Oh boy, here we go.
Here's a video recapping the Space Jump. It is a viable achievement, or did the guy just waste a bunch of money and time? If so, at least he wasted Red Bull's money. With a video to follow.
Like it's a viable achievement, according to me. I'm telling you.
I want to do it.
What do you guys think? What do you think, Dan?
Watch right now. Watch the video. Watch it.
Oh. I've seen it. It's great stuff.
Stand down. I'm
done. Sorry. It's still climbing
and we'll start beating. If we get 100 Facebook likes, I'll do this.
Okay.
100 Facebook likes and like a couple million dollars. Space.
Is that how much it costs?
Yeah, tons of money.
Sure.
Man, he went high in the sky.
128,000 feet.
This has got to be fucking amazing.
Look at him right now. That's him in a balloon. Look, he's like, I'm going to jump out of here.
Fuck yeah, dude. Fuck yeah. All right,
Felix Baumgartner.
That's crazy.
It's like watching a
lands on his feet. That's the best part.
They didn't show it there, but he actually does break the sound barrier. Not that they could show that necessarily, but they should have at least highlighted it somehow.
That's pretty wild.
It's so amazing.
Dandy boy.
He broke the sound barrier in a free fall.
Is that the only mail we got, Dandy?
Yeah. Bunch of people following us on Twitter.
All right. Thank you to all our Twitter followers. We appreciate the love. But that is listener mail. You can email us at info@thesaucepod.com if you want to send us an email. You know we'll read it on the air.
Sure we will.
And, yeah, that's listener mail.
You've got some letters.
Master, I have mail for you.
There's a letter in your mailbox. You got mail, baby.
And we're back. Incredible.
Incredible.
Sutalure.
Let's kick it over to Saucepod International News at this time. Dateline Berlin, Germany. Man finds car 2 years after losing it.
Dang.
A man in southern Germany has been reunited with his car 2 years after forgetting where he parked. Bavarian police said on Thursday after a night of drinking in December 2010 and an unsuccessful search the next day, the vehicle's owner reported his car is missing. Authorities discovered it by chance last month after a traffic warden noticed that its inspection stickers had expired 4 kilometers from the spot where the now 33-year-old craftsman originally thought he had parked. And in the trunk were $51,000 worth of tools, including power drills and electric screwdrivers. How can that happen? How can you misplace your car for 2 years? Like, you just lost it. Like one might lose a ring or the keys.
Bath salts.
Good.
The cause of and solution to all of life's problems.
Yeah. Bath salts. Yeah.
Bath salts. So that's quite a story, huh?
Wasn't that a movie?
Dude, Where's My Car? That's right.
That's right.
Ashton Kutcher.
And then? No, and then.
There wasn't another one?
No, that's just the line for the movie where they get into that fight. No, and then. And then?
And then?
No, never, and then. I've never seen that movie. Would you?
Oh, you should.
Really?
Oh, yeah, it's worth
bad.
It.
Really?
Just for that part alone, it's worth it.
I don't think I made it through the first 10 minutes.
Oh, just for that scene alone.
It's so stupid.
Dude.
Where's my car?
What's my tattoo say?
Dude. No, what's my...
See, that movie's funny. So you know it. It's culturally relevant.
I know the first 10 minutes. It happens in the first 10 minutes.
Dateline Denmark. Small penis contest. A big deal in Denmark.
Dang.
It's the little things that matter. At least that's the case in a Denmark-based competition that is offering an iPhone to the man with the smallest penis. The contest is sponsored by erotica website singlesex.dk, and site owner Morten Fabricius admits the idea is weird and funny and almost too much.
You got that, hunting dog? Singlesex.dk?
It's a competition which is at the core of manhood, the most important thing for a man, he said, according to rawstory.com. There are so many unhappy men out there who think you have to have a giant penis, but it's not normal to have a huge one. Contestants are asked to send a photo to the website of their erect sex organ with measuring tape next to it. The man with the smallest penis will win an iPhone, as will another fellow who will be chosen by the site's female members.
The only way you can win is if your penis is smaller than the new 5.5-inch screen.
Yeah, I'm sure that the guys who come in second and third place will get an iPad. Wow. A small penis contest has only been going on for a short time.
I won.
But the site has already received a half dozen photos.
No, I won.
Me and Dandy, we both won.
Now,
look at this.
Now, an iPad is worth more than
I won second
an
place.
iPhone.
Mine is slightly bigger than the smallest.
I know that site.
What?
It's RT Sports.
It is RT Sports. My penis is slightly bigger than the smallest.
So second and third place prizes are worth more than the first place prize.
It depends.
I think that the new iPhone's more than an iPad.
The biggest one's only like $600. Those are like $899.
Nah, it depends. No.
No, those iPads are like $499, right?
Oh, are they?
I don't really know.
Either way, you.
Oh yeah, I paid for that fucking iPad.
It's my wife's.
So did you? So did you?
So did I.
So did you?
I paid for it.
Some of it. Cool. I want stuff that other people pay for, though. You know what I mean?
All right.
Dandy's alluding to the fact that Saucy Joe's wife is a teacher, and that was a school-provided laptop or iPad.
Oh, boy. Yeah, there's something.
If you want stuff that other people pay for, then, you know.
What do I got to do?
Sounds like some socialist talk, Dandy.
Vote Obama.
Right.
I'm voting Roseanne this year.
Roseanne?
Fuck yeah.
I think I'm going to vote for her, too.
That's the third party ticket. See what I did there?
So that's all the news I have tonight, if you can believe it or not. Not the greatest stories, I guess. Didn't spark much conversation.
What can you really say about small dicks?
Yeah, I mean,
machetes.
It's just funny that something like that exists, and that you enter by taking a photo of yourself. I mean, isn't that illegal in some to transmit?
Can't you like take photos and like scrunch them down and shit?
Photoshop that?
Well, yeah, but
I can Photoshop. I imagine
to get the prize, they verify.
Yeah, but if you had a picture, you like cut out the middle of your dick.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, you could Photoshop it.
Or if you wanted to go to the extreme, you could just actually physically cut out the middle of your dick and then take a picture of it.
And reattach it.
That's probably an
I imagine when they went
website.
To pick up their iPad, they were like, all right, drop trout so we can make sure that...
The guy who wins it just got a fucking monster.
Right.
And get a wreck. Too bad there wasn't a largest Baxis contest going on to win an iPhone.
You would probably win in this room.
Oh, my
so gross.
So bad. It hurts. It was a bloodbath, too.
Foreign bodies.
Blood everywhere.
Ugh.
There was actually, I didn't realize it, but when I got up and saw like the remnants of everything they used, I mean, it was a bloodbath.
You should get a tramp stamp over it.
The blood rolled down my, I didn't even feel it, but when they were cleaning me up, they had to wipe me up on like my shoulder in the front. I was
oh,
like,
it was up that high?
It was in the, no, it was back here, but the blood had somehow spilled down under me in front.
Blood everywhere.
And the paper I was laying on. Was blood soaked.
I'm picturing like in your tramp stamp area.
Yeah.
No, up. It was up top. It hurts. It really hurts right now.
Pussy.
They had to dig that out. They had to dig deep. So I watched The Walking Dead this week.
I watched.
I didn't watch the new episode though, so I don't want to know exactly what happened.
I haven't watched yet either, so let's not spoil it.
I watched season two.
I watched season two
and finished watching season two on Saturday night, and I was like, damn, I'm all out of Walking Deads. And then I realized, oh, the new episode starts tomorrow.
Yeah, it's pretty awesome.
So
too.
Great time. We've recommended that show before on this episode, but I'm going to do it right now again. And Hunting Dog, you want to recommend a show?
I want to recommend Homeland, man. It's really, you know, it's...
This week was a good episode of Homeland.
It's edgy shit. That's good stuff.
It's edgy.
I've heard good things. I have heard that the best show on all of TV though is Breaking Bad, and
I don't watch that.
I don't watch it either, but I'm thinking I should.
Great. It's great.
You watch this too?
It's awesome.
Oh man, I wish I watched that. No. So fuck up, Dave.
Sounds like Rain Man.
About $100.
It's probably true.
Tremé is great too.
Tremé is really.
Yeah,
good.
I haven't watched the most recent one. But
Jesse likes Tremé.
Like Joe, that's Saucy Joe to you.
Yeah, Saucy Joe likes Tremé. Fuck Tremé.
Speaking of Saucy Joe, I did post a video on Google Plus of my son calling out a magician at a birthday party.
Want me to pull it up?
Yeah, if you want.
I love that.
I cut the segment down to so you can see. I'll set up the clip while you're doing it. Basically, my son was a volunteer at the magician show. And the magician sort of tricked him, and then the kids laughed, and my son didn't care for that. Like, the kids, he thought they were laughing at him, and he quickly turned on the magician. And, well, the results are...
And you got it all on video?
I did.
Is it awesome?
It's pretty good.
Does he, like, break down?
No. He almost... I thought he was gonna.
Yeah.
I'm glad...
He kind of does.
I'm glad that... what happened is what happened, instead of him breaking down, because I thought he might.
Instead, he turned it on. Turned it on the old performer, huh?
Yeah. He's working. He's doing his video magic.
So I started a Instagram the other day. Never had one before.
Oh, no.
Look at that picture.
Oh, look at that. What is it? Kingston.
Can you
it's
share?
Danny's dog.
Can you share with the camera?
Kind of.
Oh, shit.
He's got a winter hat on.
Dude, it's a dog, man. I put my dog down like yesterday.
It was a few weeks ago, man. Yeah.
it was 2 weeks ago. It's tough. It's still tough.
You can borrow mine.
It's tough, bro. You know it's tough.
Yeah, I can imagine. Just
put a Tucker down, man. Fucking tough.
It is. He's a man's best friend.
Yeah, it is.
So I'm going to play this video.
Yesterday he lost like 10 dogs, man. I'm not laughing, but yeah.
Yeah. So this is children laughing at a magician's trick, and my son taking offense and then turning on the magician.
Right. Stand down for a second, hun dog. Stand down, my friend.
Sorry.
It's loading. Actually, it went full screen. Hold on a second. I got to get a better shot. Okay.
Okay. It looks like me like watching the soccer game, man, right there. This guy's like fucking. Look at this guy.
It's buffering. Hold on.
He's all touching your kid's face and shit.
Watch F1 soccer, man. Yep. I'll rape you. Okay, now in order to get a good fit, you need to relax your face. Like Chris Hopkins. What's he doing?
This is where he turns right here.
Oh man, buffering.
Oh man.
Oh boy. Oh boy.
Hold on, I'm gonna let this load a little bit here.
This is a good idea.
Sorry about that, guys.
It's okay.
So, now, where was this? At a birthday party?
Yeah, at a mutual friend's birthday party. We'll call her Mojo. Her daughter's birthday party. She turned 5. And she had a magician. It was fun. It was a great party. We had a good time. Kids all running around crazy.
Yes.
This must be a video of high quality.
I uploaded it. It's only 480.
He looks great right there. He looks great. Look at him.
I'm a specimen.
You look really good, man.
I'm a specimen. I do look good. You're right, Hondo. You look good, too, man.
I'm serious, man.
You're always looking good.
Oh, Danny, you look good, too, man.
Okay, guys, I think I got this. Here it goes.
All right. See, now he's mad.
No, I know.
Fucking dandy boy over here. Look at fucking Aaron. Fuck you guys.
This is the horriblest magician show ever, he says.
You don't know the half of it.
This is the horriblest magician show ever. James got mad.
Did he walk away after?
Yeah, he did. And I cut out a bunch of it before and after. There's a bunch of him just being mad, basically. But that was the highlight when he said, "This is the most horriblest birthday magician show ever." And the guy said, "No, I've definitely done worse shows than this."
Tell it like it is, Saucy James.
Yeah.
Tell it like
it was
it
a good.
Is.
It was a good moment. And then I cut out the part right after that where I said really, very loudly how proud I was of him. I'm very proud of you right now. Because I don't think the magician appreciated me saying that. But I was proud of him.
Very proud of you.
I'm proud of him.
That's it, Kevin Astray.
Oh, no.
So he was, like, talking to the whole crowd of people?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. They thought they were laughing. He thought they were laughing at him.
He thought that the kids were laughing like at him.
So he was playing it off.
He's like, oh no, no, yeah.
No. He's like, I know.
Leave me alone. He's like, he was very upset. It was a good moment for him. I had to have a talk with him afterward because he was upset that everyone was.
You
making
didn't yell
fun
at
of
him, did you?
No, they thought he thought that the kids were making fun of him, and I was trying to explain. You know, they're not laughing at you; they're laughing with you. Tried to explain that. Well, after that, the magician took a balloon and to decorate this hat for the daughter, the birthday girl, and then he had another balloon. He was going to put them both on there, and he said, "Oh, we have to figure out which is the heaviest part." And to determine that, you hold them up above your head and throw them, and when they come down, it'll turn to what the heaviest part is. But what James didn't know is that the balloon he gave my son was full of helium. So when my son threw it up, it went up in the tree, and James and the our kids all laughed again. And James was like, "No, stop laughing at me!" Like, he thought that he was getting laughed at.
Wow!
You don't do that,
Hunter.
No,
I'm not.
Bad, big mistake.
Wow. I thought this was like a liberal show, man. Like Cheech and Chong shit, man.
So he was just pissed.
You're fucking lame, bro.
Yeah, he was very upset.
Hey,
but he played
James
it off pretty well.
James is fucking lame, bro. Because I'm fucking lame.
Saucy one. James.
No, I love James. I love James. Kinda.
You and Uncle Paul.
Oh, that's right.
What's going on in the chat room, Danny? We missing anything?
Oh, shit.
Not really.
Kind of quiet night tonight.
Roger.
Always glad to have Roger along. Jay Nasty probably gave up about half an hour ago.
He's got a kid to get ready for.
That's right.
What does she do? She's due.
If you guys mean Jay Nasty, you mean like Jay Pearl. He was down at Red and drunk, man, yeah. Trying to get some shit going, yeah.
On a Monday night.
Yes. What else are you going to do on a Monday night, baby?
Well, all
right, whatever. Yeah, whatever.
Did you guys hear about the new phenomenon, butt chugging?
I have heard of butt chugging.
I have no idea what that is.
Sue has a daughter.
Whatever you think it is, it is.
Or a kid.
Just
or herself.
The name, whatever's in your head, you're right.
No, it's not.
Yes.
Really, butt chugging? Do you care?
It's like doing a funnel of beer, but in your ass.
I don't know what that means.
Because it seeps right into your bloodstream.
All right.
Girls have been dunking their tampons in like vodka and shit.
Right. I've heard of that.
Right.
It's pretty much.
Or taking an enema.
Yeah, they left it of alcohol. With your daughter, yeah.
What's that?
She's going to dip her tampon in the fuck.
What?
No, she's only six.
I don't think she's going to do that.
No,
probably not, but you never know.
It's something like
you do never know. It's a scary thing.
Jackass would do.
There's a story about
some kid from, I would say, somewhere in Michigan. What are you doing, Hunt Dog?
Here later or no?
He died, didn't he? He didn't die, but he had a his alcohol blood content level was like 0.4.
I think I've been there before.
0.4, like five times the legal limit.
That's crazy.
And he was like, no, I wasn't butt chugging. And I guess they like there was some clear evidence.
Stuck a breathalyzer in his asshole, and they were like, here it is.
No, I think he had some bleeding issues. From his ass.
It would probably eat away your asshole tissue, huh?
Well, that or just, you know, putting a funnel in your ass.
That too.
Yeah.
I know. What are these kids up to these days? Doing stuff
what
like
happened
that?
To the old sitting Doodle. In a shed with funnels some funnels fucking old Milwaukees?
And when we did funnels, we put it in our mouth.
Yeah, I remember that. I remember.
Not our butt. We didn't put anything in our butt.
Nothing in our butt, yeah.
I don't think anybody in my age would have been down with that.
Even Chris Hayes didn't put anything in
his butt. No. I'm still not down with it.
He kicked somebody's ass, so he wouldn't put anything in his butt, yeah.
You know, we tried a lot of things in those days, but if anything had to
Chris
go up the butt.
Chris Hayes would beat some old ladies up, yeah.
If anything had to go up the butt.
I'm just kidding, yeah.
I'm all right.
Dandy boy. Come here.
I'm all set.
Fucking cocksucker.
I'm all set.
What? Oh, Jesus Christ, really?
We actually do have time to talk about the behavioral sync by Will Wales tonight. But I tell you what, I think it's best that we put a wrap on this one.
Probably right.
I think Rudy P. Ringtone really wanted to hear that story.
Are we talking about Rudy?
Yeah, Rudy P. Ringtone, we should have mentioned, he's not here tonight because his car broke down in Maryland.
He's Jewish, too.
It's the other reason he couldn't make it tonight. Yeah.
I'm sorry. I love Rudy.
I love the Jewish people.
I know. So do I. I love that bread they make. Right, Stu? Huh?
Come on, matzo ball, Stu.
Fuck it. All right. Yeah, whatever. Just me. Come on. Jesus Christ, that was the quiet, man.
Yeah, it's dead air.
Yeah,
it's some dead air.
Coming up this week on the FingerLakes1.com network, we got Kenny's Two Pennies tomorrow at 4 o'clock p.m. live. That's Tuesday. Then on Wednesday night, we got Lake to Lake podcast, our Lake to Lake Girls podcast with Tiffany and Amanda. That goes live at 6, followed by the Chew Gum podcast at 8, live with your host, Bub, Jay Nasty, Tito, and Q. 31st Lap Boys are back, the gang, the motor racing gang of thugs, of motor racing thugs. They're back at 7:15 on Thursday night. And then, of course, on Saturday at 11, it's Tech Talk Live with Flipper JJ and Snide. And on Ooh, Sunday morning this week, there's another episode of Musical Viral Spiral with P-Spot. That's
network,
at 11.
The network is humming right now.
Friend zone.
Yeah, then we'll be back on Monday morning at 9:30, Weber on Sports. And then you guessed it, 8 p.m. next Monday, it'll be episode 75 of the Sauce Pod with 50% less hunting dogs.
I get suicide.
And then at 9 o'clock, we broadcast an episode of Homeland on the Fingerlings.
You don't even know what that means. We never watched it.
Hunting Dog, you should have a Homeland podcast where you just talk nothing about Homeland. Those shows like that are really successful.
Do they ever watch Homeland?
There's a Breaking Bad one. I watch Homeland. Pretty good.
And there's The Talking Dead.
I'm not talking about Breaking Bad.
I listen to a Game of Thrones podcast.
Jim Lang's fucking, yeah.
The same people, I think, do also do a Breaking Bad one as well.
You like Breaking Bad? You like fucking Homeland?
There's a Big Brother podcast. I don't know if you ever saw that, Stu. I know that you watch Big Brother, you and Dandy.
I think we should do a Behavioral Sync podcast.
Only about the Behavioral Sync by Will Wales?
Yep.
If you guys are, you know, our regular listeners are wondering what that is, put it into Google and read it for yourself, because we're never going to get to it.
No, we never have time.
But it is a real interesting topic that we'll save for more heady times.
Heavy times?
Heady and heavy. Tonight's pretty heavy. I'm not going to lie.
I hear you, bro.
Heavy times tonight.
I'm talking about E.C. Slater, bro. Heavy times.
E.C. Slater?
Talking about.
Do you know they play Saved by the Bell on Saturday morning?
Really? I saw Mario Lopez too? At fucking the Carolina Mall, man. Back in 2012.
That was this year.
It was Slater, bro. It was Slater.
Slater, bro. Slater.
Screech wasn't happy about it. Because Lisa Turtle didn't like it.
Lisa Turtle.
Hey, Mama.
God. Stand down. Oh, hunting dog.
I'm sorry.
Well, that'll do it for episode number 74 of the Sauce Pod. Thanks for tuning in. Make sure you like us on Facebook. We're right at the precipice, right at the brim. So check us out.
We hope you enjoyed listening to this episode of the Sauce Podcast. Subscribe to our feed at thesaucepod.com. Look for us on iTunes and the Zune Marketplace. Contact us at info@thesaucepod.com. Follow us on Twitter at twitter.com/thesaucepod. We'll see you next week. www.fingerlakes1.com